Hello all, today we are going to discuss about the recipe management in color mixer. So you can see this is my color mixer. I have the three primary colors, red, green and blue, and there are three solenoid valves which will be opened during the mixing application, and I have the three outputs, magenta, cyan and yellow, and I have a reset option and a load option and a mixing tank and a mixer also. This is my configuration. The configuration is maintained by, it's controlled by the recipe management, and because during the runtime you can see that this is my management. I have to load the magenta first. By loading magenta, the red and blue are mixing in 50-50 proportion, and the valves are opened by here, and by clicking the load button you can see the colors are loaded to the bottom tank or the mixing tank. I can mix with the mixer tank. You can see that it is mixing, and I can reset from here. Everything is zero and every valves are zero, and I can load the cyan color. You can see the green and blue in the 50-50 proportion, and valves are opening. And reset and go to the yellow. You can see that the red and green are in the 50-50 proportion. This is the recipe management. This management is done by the recipe manager, and I will show you the basics of the recipe management. Only the recipe manager I'm going to show in my video, because this animation configuration is a little bit tough to learn, or tough to, it's a little bit time consuming. So I'll show you the recipe management only. Here guys, on the beginning I have to open a new window, and I have to click, I have to draw some buttons from here. Here I have to duplicate these buttons. I need 5 buttons, and duplicating I got 5 buttons. You can see that one is for magenta. I'm not taking the 5 application, I'm not setting the load application also. So this is magenta, and I have to set substitute to substitute strings and set as magenta. Here you can see I have taken this button configuration, magenta, cyan, yellow and reset and load buttons. I have to put some tanks. For the tanks, I'm simply drawing the rectangle. Here I have 3 ingredients, red, green and blue. These are my 3 primary colors. I have to assign in align in a line, and have to put a basin, or the basin or the output tank. Here you can see the, here is the output tank, and then I have to maintain some values. Double click on the tank and percentage fill, that will be R, red. For representing the red, I will take R and OK. Define red, yes. And memory type is IO, integer, OK. Access name galaxy, use tank name as second name, and save it and close it, OK. And the green one, I have to give the vertical G, OK. Define like the previous times, memory real, sorry, memory integer. Sorry, IO integer, and the access name is galaxy, use tag name as submit ATM name, save it and close it. Okay. And this is the last one is blue, RGB. Okay, blue, and define B like the previous times, IO integer. Okay, use tag name as ATM name, save it and close it. These are my 3 configurations, and this is my tank T, the total filling tank T. This is the vertical, and I don't have to add the maximum fill has 100 value, maximum fill has 100, have to give 300 because it is a big tank, and have to give the expression as T for the total. So define the also, that is also an IO integer. Okay, access the galaxy, use tag name as item name, and save it and close it. Okay, then I have to go to the recipe management. Here you can see on the left side, you can see the applications and open the applications. On the bottom you can see the recipe manager. Double click on the recipe manager, you can see in the black color. Double click, and I have to create a new recipe. To go to options, preferences, and how many items I have. I have only 3 items, RGB. These are my 3 items, and only 1 unit. And number of recipes are 4, because we are using the magenta, cyan and yellow. Then on reset button also. That is my 4 configurations. And okay, these are my 4 recipes. And go to find new. This you can see the red, I can type it red, red, press enter, blue, enter, green. Have typed all my colors, my in my inputs or my primary colors or my items, and go to the item type and A and enter, because that will automatically make the analog. A enter, A enter. Have created the analog tags. And you can see the recipe. My first recipe is magenta. Enter. for the magenta, I'm setting the values of red and green as 50-50 configuration. 50 and blue as, sorry, green as 50. Okay, and the blue is 0. This is my configuration, 50 configuration of red and green. That will make the magenta. That is up to you. The mixing is totally up to you. So magenta cyan. CYA cyan. Enter. And have to give the values as 50 and 50 and 0. My third recipe will be yellow. I'm just giving YELLOW. Yellow. My third configuration will be 0, 50 and 50. My recipe 4 is reset. So I have to reset every values that or the values will be 0. That is the my reset configuration, and I also minimize that, and I have to put a unit. Unit as A. I just given a random name A, and the red, the vertical increment tag for the red tag is R, and the blue tag is B, and the green tag is G. Now created all our recipes and we have to save it. Go to file, save. You can see that during the saving, I have to save on the desktop and have given name as K. K.csv, that is my file name. Smaller K.csv. I have to save it and close it. Minimize that and can see the K.csv and go to the properties. And you can see the file path location. I have to copy the file path location first. Copy, close it and back to SCADA. And I have to give the recipe load. Can double click and action, first button magenta, and how to recipe load file, go to all functions to find recipe load. You can see the recipe load here, double click, and here you can see the file name. I have to paste my file name, file location, control V. Okay, you can see the control V, C, users. Okay, I have to put the control where file name in the quotations. So desktop. And the file name will not end here. Go to put a slash and k.csv. That is my file extension. I have to put another quotation and close it. And the unit name. Unit name, my unit name was A. I have to put that also in the quotation. And the unit name is over and the recipe name was magenta. And the quotation I have to give magenta. And closing with the quotation. Have completed the first scripting of the recipe magenta here and validate. Okay, and I have to give the same for the cyan. Have to go to action and change only the magenta to cyan. CYAN cyan and validate and okay. Okay, also for the yellow. For the yellow, you can see the action. Then you have to change the cyan to yellow. YELLOW yellow. And validate. Okay. Okay. And the reset. Have to set the recipe for the reset also. Yellow. Change it to reset. Reset. Validate. And okay. Okay. And go to the load. In the load button, the action should be T equal to total equal to T equal to R plus G plus B, red plus green plus blue, that is the action that has to be taken. R plus G plus B, validate, expecting semicolon, have to put a semicolon also, validate and OK. That will be shown here. This is the T, you can see the vertical field is T and the value is 300, maximum value is 300 and OK. And go to the runtime. By going to the runtime, you can see that, ignore everything, and you can see the first magenta. You can see the red and green in the 50-50 proportion and I have to load it. By loading it, you have to see that this loading value, you have to reset it. And the cyan, you can see that red and blue are in the 50-50 proportion. And also in the yellow, you can see the green and blue in the 50-50 proportion. Now my proportion may not be wrong, the opinion may not be right. So you have to give your own proportion. So this is the recipe management. Hope you understand the recipe management. So subscribe. Like, share, and thank you.